Alright, what the fudge are we talking about?
Final Fantasy versus 13.
Yes!
/ 15.
Oh my gosh, where do we begin? How do we do this? Because there's so much shit to cover.
I want
to
start with the good stuff before we get into all this negativity.
The good stuff? Okay.
Okay, so that'll only take about 30 seconds.
Shit.
Okay.
What did you like? Okay, there's one thing I really like, but I don't know how you want to do this.
Yeah, let's start with all the good stuff. So, I'm going to say graphically, it was beautiful. It was no refined.
It wasn't Uncharted.
It wasn't Uncharted, but I mean, look at the map they're dealing with.
Yeah.
The rendering, I mean, it has had its rendering issues, had all that good stuff every once in a while. But, you know, I played through the majority of the game and didn't have any rendering issues. Mm-hmm. But I played on the Pro. Have they updated it for the Pro yet?
I don't think so.
No, I don't know. Once they update it for the Pro, I might touch it again. But I don't think there's much difference between the Pro and the regular PS4 right now with the game. But graphically I liked it. The side quests didn't feel like as taskmastery, much chores as I thought they were going to be. There's still some that I want to do, like some of the hunter missions and stuff. But it did like remind me a lot of like Monster Hunter, God Eater, kind of like, here, collect this bounty, go, kill this monster.
Those are probably my favorite side missions, to be honest, though.
Yeah, they are, because they're not collect shit. Yeah. It's like, go and beat, and then when you get higher in level, they get difficult. Yeah. They get harder than the actual main storyline.
Yeah, which is pretty good.
But yeah.
There are some missions I stopped halfway through, like, stupid, take this photo. What's that guy's name?
Jared?
No.
Oh, shit, what's his name?
You know what I'm talking about.
His name is Siv. S-Y-V.
S-Y-V?
Yeah, I think.
The guy with the ponytail?
Yeah, the guy with the ponytail.
Yeah.
He looks like a Boogie from YouTube.
Oh my god. Wow. Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Those missions are stupid.
Listen, they're worth doing. The only reason they're worth doing is because you get hella money from them.
Yeah.
But yeah, they are a pain in the ass because you're just in that car just driving places or fast traveling, whatever. It's like, that was another mechanic that was interesting to me, was the driving and the fast traveling. It's like,
that was weird.
There were some things you can get from driving manual, like from driving manually, especially before you get the headlights.
Headlights.
Like, you never got the head. You never installed the headlights.
I don't know.
Where you can drive at night.
Oh. Well, I could drive at night now. So.
Okay, so you got them somewhere down there. You had to get over this junk. You had to go to this dungeon, I believe, and fight through it. But.
Wait. So if you never got those headlights, you couldn't drive at night for.
No, because the demons would stop. The demons would pop up in front of the car, and you'd have to fight them.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
That was a cool little mechanic. But other than that, I just felt like the driving, I spent like a third of the game just on the road.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay. When it got linear, see, this is so like catch-22 for me, because it was like, I liked the world that they had. I liked the open world that they had, but I wouldn't have minded a smaller map, to be honest. Mm-hmm. I honestly wouldn't have been fazed by that. I wouldn't have minded more linear story missions.
Yeah.
They were very linear at the very end.
The driving, the thing is, like, they showed a shit ton of content before the game came out, where some of it was where you could drive off-road.
Yeah, I remember that.
They got rid of that bullshit.
Yeah.
God.
And Avi was telling us, you know, how he hated that it was like sandbox. It wasn't even like open world.
Mm.
But that's just semantics. Like, of course there's boundaries on every open world game. Like, come on. And of course there are, like, this game was really restricted open world. Like, you couldn't go off world, like you said.
And there's this, I don't know if you saw it, but there have been these videos where this guy finds a way to, like,
glitch above the map.
or like out of the map.
Where, I saw the screenshot. I didn't watch the video.
Where he's like, I guess you can't go to those places normally, unless you do the glitch. And there's like a bunch of places where he walks that's not in the final game, but you could actually walk there.
Oh, you mean like assets that were outside of the map?
Yeah.
Yeah, they do that in like almost games. And yeah, they were cool looking?
Yeah, they're almost like fully developed. They just didn't have any...
What's DLC?
Yeah, like, they didn't have any monsters and shit, but...
Disc launch content.
Apparently there were roads and like cars there too, but I don't know.
Yeah,
That's sad to know that.
It's... You know, the saddest part is... They did great with... I think they did great with the animal AI. I think the creatures were great. The landscapes were good. But like you said, it was just like... you get to a point in the game where you're just like... Is this it? Like, is this it? Is this like all 10 years? Like, this is... Like, I expected a beautiful landscape. I expected good graphics. But... When you actually get to the substance of the story, when you get to the substance of the build up, this multimedia kind of experience where you have to watch the anime, watch the Kingsglaive, and the anime not as important. I didn't even watch all of them. I only watched like 3 of them.
Yeah.
But
well, that's the other thing is like it's kind of probably bad if you have to have an animated show the different characters.
Yeah, and
it still didn't really help.
They could have taken the time, like the duration of Kingsglaive, the duration of the anime, added that time to the game and given us a little more context.
Yeah.
And I absolutely hated. Okay, I'm done with my good parts. Basically, the combat was.
Well, what do you want? Do you want to cover story or gameplay first?
Okay. I'm still in the good parts. I actually enjoyed the combat. It was very casual, like you and I talked about. Really easy.
Yeah.
In terms of picking up and playing, anyone can do it and live through a few battles and not even worry about dying or anything. I thought it looked cool. I mean, especially when you get newer weapons and stuff.
Yeah.
But
that's the thing for me. For me, the thing I hated about it was. Well, it's obviously autopilot.
Yeah.
There's something about the satisfaction of, I don't know, pushing a button every time.
And an action happening.
Yeah, exactly. Yes, I don't know how to explain, but there's just a satisfaction of that where you feel it in every other game. Like
you feel like, because you feel like you're actually controlling the combat. You feel like you're dictating his moves. This is the thing. A perfect example is Warp Strike.
Yeah.
It doesn't happen as soon as you hit the button. Right. You hold, it's like there's a delay. You hold it, there's like this charge up, and it goes, and then he teleports. Which, they might have done that for effect, but the combat is another one. Like, obviously, heavier weapons move slower. I can appreciate them trying to get that mechanic down. But even the small weapons, it's like, you'll be like, tap, 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 and he's like, swing, swing.
Yeah.
What? And you're holding down circles, so it's like, and there is no control.
Yeah, and there's so much, sometimes, a lot of times, actually, there are moments where there's too many enemies on the field, so it was really hard to use a great sword for a lot of times.
Oh yeah, because you just get wrecked as soon as you pull back to swing.
Exactly,
or
you're too slow. So.
And I think they tried to counteract that with that tactical mode or whatever. Did you ever use that tactical mode?
The weight mode?
Yeah, the weight mode, yeah.
I never used the weight
mode. Yeah, I tried it a few times and I'm just like, this is stupid. This is bullshit. It's like, I'd rather you just like change the whole landscape to turn-based again.
Right.
And I would have more... It wasn't intuitive. It wasn't that... It wasn't easy to use. There was like no tutorial on it. Mm-hmm. So like you go to it and it's like... You see this timer and like triangle for warp strike. And you're just like... What is this for? Like, is it camera mode? Like, is that what we're doing here? Like, shit, I don't know.
I didn't spend anything on the weight mode at all.
Yeah, it wasn't worth it. It would have made it way more unenjoyable anyway, because then you really would have felt like you weren't doing shit. Mm-hmm. But no, I could get that, because, like, a good example is, like, Devil May Cry and God of War. In that combat, you really do feel like you're beating the shit out of them.
Exactly.
And, that's gratifying.
Same thing with Nier, the new game.
Oh, yeah.
oh man, and Bayonetta.
Yeah, that's such a good comparison. I'm like, because Square can make games like this. It's just that they were...
Yeah, Kingdom Hearts.
I mean, yeah, even if they would have just copy-pasted, like, Kingdom Hearts mechanics, it would have still felt more gratifying to kill things.
That's what I wanted from the very beginning.
Yeah.
God. See, like, I guess we have to give them the fact that even though we waited 10 years for the game, it was only really in development for, like, 5 years.
That's true, because they changed it. They shook everything up.
Which is bullshit, by the way. One more thing about the combat is that it was really annoying to me too. It was like, I don't know if I was just doing it wrong, but there was moments where, because I wasn't, I usually didn't do the lock on.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't do that, so I would just hold the attack button. He would run up to the guy across the map and there was someone right next to him.
Oh like, my gosh, really? Yes.
That's so annoying. That auto, what is that? The homing device, the way he homes into an enemy?
Yeah.
That was annoying because in most other games like that, hack and slash, you gotta face who you wanna attack.
Yeah.
They don't home in on the bad guy.
Yeah.
That was annoying.
The point about that was this is getting into the friendly AI.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. There would be times where you're just like, dude, I'm bleeding out over here, and Gladio's you have like one guy alive.
Yeah.
And you don't want to waste your potions. You're like, come on, I got like full health. Just come get me right now.
Yeah.
And you're just like, there's no command to bring him over.
Exactly.
And like, and Gladio's just chopping away at the enemy. And I'm like over here walking away from combat.
That's the other thing is the fact that I feel like everything was not fully developed. Everything was half developed because, oh my gosh, you couldn't command your...
Yeah, ally. There was another thing. That
should have been a given.
Dragon Age had that option.
Yeah.
Dragon Age was way more fucking tactical than that. And, I couldn't believe that. I just couldn't believe it wasn't more refined because I wasted half of my elixirs, half of my potions, half of everything on the account of them not just turning around, running over real quick, taking 1 second to pull me up, and then we can beat the ass.
Exactly.
Because, like, a friendly AI would know, oh, I can just revive four of my allies and we can beat the shit out of this thing instead of me just whacking away until I die.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what? And the worst is Prompto. Dude, shit. Oh, yeah, Prompto is the last one alive. Yeah, which never happens. He's never the last one alive. He's always the first one down.
Uh-huh.
But, oh, gosh. I the only items I put on Prompto were fucking health items. Because he went down so much.
Yeah. You mean like gear?
Mm-hmm, yeah,
me too.
And I was like, but yeah, so the friendly AI, I would be so frustrated in the screen because we'd be fighting a boss or whatever. And I would miss the block or I'd miss the parry and I would get like wrecked early game. Yeah. And I'm like looking at the team, like one of you three can't come over and get me? Like,
yeah, that's the thing is like, I think I'm not sure if other Final Fantasies did it. I feel like they did, but you should be able to like specify like their
actions, their commands, yeah, and their reactions.
If you want him to be a healer or a caster or whatever, like have a priority.
Yeah, that was something that even Kingdom Hearts had that. It was that you had Donald, Goofy, and your other party member, and you had to switch on one of them out, but it had like when they use your potions, you could say never use the potions.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, stuff like that.
Exactly.
And granted, in this game, they never use their potions without you telling them to. But you also can't designate their defense.
Exactly.
Whether they're a defender or an attacker, aggressive or passive.
All that should have been in the game.
Yeah, and I'm like, they're gonna. What sucks is honestly, it's past the point where I think they care enough to where they're going to actually try to add features like that. Because honestly, everyone who's been waiting for this game's already beat this game.
Yeah.
Because of we've been waiting to see what the story is.
Yeah.
But damn did I fucking call that they were gonna fucking kill off Luna. Shit, like... combat, like, for me, it was like 50-50. Like, half the time, I was mesmerized, especially in those hunting missions. Mm-hmm. I haven't fought the Adamantoids yet.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, but just, like, looking at some of the bosses, the Griffin battles were cool. Warp striking in the air, like, air striking, that was really, really cool.
Did you ever get to fight that Big Bird?
I have the mission for it, but I haven't went and
studied. How do you get, where is that?
It's at the crag, Rakatal Crag or whatever, Rakatal Crag.
Huh.
That mountain you have to climb up. Did you climb up that mountain? Where you like slide down if you waste stamina just climbing, and you have to like go into the rock, regain stamina, go up, regain stamina.
I don't think so.
Okay,
so
yeah.
So you can actually fight that bird where you're
the
like,
one at the beginning of the game with the when you gain the thing for the jeweler.
Yeah.
Yeah. You that's where he lives is on the top of that mountain.
Okay.
There's like a huge arena where it's all nests. You can see these giant ass nests. But yeah, so they did a good job on the creature development, like the art direction there. That was cool. And then I haven't played all Final Fantasies, but I know that they were homages to like creatures from multiple Final Fantasies in the game.
Yeah.
The chocobos were enjoyable. I had fun with that, but after a while, it's just like they don't go fast enough.
Yeah.
And you know,
after a certain chapter, you don't use them anymore.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
Unless you go like.
Back in time,
yeah.
But gain skills and weapons that you can use in the future. From what? Like what? Like Umbra? What are you fucking like Doctor Who's like telephone booth? Like I don't understand that shit.
Exactly.
Damn. Well, I'm like, damn. Why didn't that dog save the day? Go back 2,000 years ago and kill this fucking prophecy shit. I don't know.
Exactly. And
go save fucking Luna. What the fuck?
Why do you also have to pay for the chocobos? That didn't make any sense.
Oh my god!
Any sense
don't
at
fucking
all.
Get me started on that! It's like, yeah, do 12 missions for me at the farm? And oh, by the way, you can rent them from me after you do all these favors for me. Oh, there's an injured chocobo. I'm like, damn, I've paid my dues, dude. Just let me have... And it's your chocobo. You're renting your own chocobo.
Yeah.
What the fuck? You name it? You put colors on it? You put badges on it? They're like, oh, well, you know, we... Oh, it doesn't make sense why the chocobo all of a sudden be like, oh, I gotta go back to the farm. Like, oh, I have to leave. If you need me, just...
Yeah.
Just
yeah, it's
call me. Like, what... It was a waste of money. It wasn't not granted. It wasn't a lot of money,
yeah,
but
it was a lot of money.
It
but...
still was just like, why?
Yeah, why?
Why can't I just pull you out of my pocket and use you? I don't understand that.
I don't know what you're thinking. And I had to ask this. I never got the payment system where, let's say it was 30. It would say 30 gil and then their arrow and then 15 gil.
What? Yes! In the fucking hotels, right?
For anything.
For anything. And it would have like a half price.
Yeah, I did that.
Do I get a collector's edition discount? Is that what's going on right now?
I'm wondering. Is that for everybody or is that because we bought...
Oh, some? You're the prince. Let me take that down a little bit.
Yeah, I don't get that. So is that... In the game intentionally?
I don't know.
Or is that because we got... It's not because we got collector's edition. Right?
I don't know, dude. I never looked it up, but I always was like, why is my hotel tab half? Why is my chocobo tab half? Why is my food tab half? Like,
I was so confused about that.
And why the hell am I going to pay $8,000 for a plate of eggs? Like, what the fuck? Like, just so Ignis can write down the recipe and call it something different.
Yeah. Oh,
oh yeah, I made this. This is original.
Oh gosh. I'm surprised he's able to cook after being blind.
What do you mean? Show him cooking at the end? And I'm like, you're fucking blind, dude. What are you feeling the ingredients? Are you feeling how hot the pan is?
Gosh.
It would make more sense if they had like Prompto or Gladio standing next to him and be like, what do I do next?
Oh my gosh. Oh, that's hilarious.
Shit. And those time like continuities were so bad because Luna had died and I had gone back in the past. And then looked at the wedding dress and everyone's like, oh yeah, I can't wait. Like, I can't wait until like the wedding and Gladio. You go back in the past and Gladio and Prompto and Ignis are talking about it. I'm like,
oh my gosh,
dude, they're dead. Like, she's dead. She's dead. Like,
and the other thing is, I don't know. I guess for me, I still wish there were more towns where you could like actually go in and fight.
Oh, yeah. There was only, what? There was really only three. Yeah. Well,
or
two?
Yeah.
Alticia and whatever the fuck that place is called.
Yeah. We didn't really get that city fighting in the city that I wanted until the end. See, that's the kind of mission I wanted throughout the game.
I was hoping that there would be a mission, like, early on, like, maybe even halfway through the game, where you went back into the city.
Yeah,
exactly. And you reclaimed it, or you cleared out a part of it to where you could explore. Cause
exactly.
You go in there and you're like, wow, this place is really cool.
Yeah.
You don't even go, you really only walk through a subway and down a street and you're done with the game. Like, what exactly. The hell?
All that shit was cut, damn it. And speaking of cut content, there's everything from basically 2012 and before was cut. Which is really, really sad. And then the whole, what was it? Remember the 2013 trailer we saw? Where they're being invaded and he's
running through the train or he's running through the building, the collapsing building.
Yeah. Where he's fighting the Leviathan. Shit was cut.
Yep.
Which is really sad.
And
the fighting in the, well, I guess he fought Ifrit there, but. Oh, God.
I just, like, I'm so disappointed that you don't, like, if you don't go back and play the game after, post-story, you will never be able to use Ifrit.
Yeah.
Like, and I'm just like, oh, like, the moment right before you fight the final boss, it's like, oh, you've gained, like, whatever, the Firestone or whatever the fuck, like, it says the element, like, to summon him.
Mm-hmm.
You're just like, wow, that's real helpful now. I'm sure I won't be summoning him in this next battle.
Yeah.
Sure I won't be summoning anything in this next battle. And, man.
Did you...
Shiva was stupid.
Are you able to use Shiva?
I've used her once, I think. Or I saw...
Out of the boss battle? Like, not the boss battle?
Oh, no, I haven't tried it since. No, yeah, but yeah, it's just...
I don't know if you can. That's what I'm wondering.
I hope you can. Like, shit, those Shiva and Ifrit are like... And Bahamut. Like, that was a sick one, but that wasn't even on your own.
Yeah. Yeah, let's talk about the summons. What the fuck?
I can understand why it's random, but why it doesn't occur more, I don't get that.
Yeah.
Like, it... Throughout my whole playthrough, and I was at, like... Dude, I was at hella hours. I can't remember how many hours it was. I want to say like 60-something hours.
Mm-hmm.
And I had only used a summon 8 times, I think. 8 fucking times. And plus, because there were just times where there was one enemy left. And I'm like, I'm not going to waste this whole fucking animation for one guy.
Yeah.
I only did it, I think I did it on the fucking, what do you call that? That big-ass long neck... dinosaur looking shit in the lake. I can't remember what it's called. It's like a long ass name.
The Clio or the whatever. Something. Yeah.
Kataplopos?
Something like
Kataplopos or whatever. Yeah. That thing I used it on because I was low level and I was like, fuck you, get Rama, bitch. Like, and he just dies.
I think it feels like it only triggers when you're in jeopardy or something.
Yeah, and that's.
Which is bullshit.
Yeah.
He's like a scapegoat.
I miss like classic Final Fantasy where it's like if you got the fucking AP and it's like cooldown, just fucking summon it. Like,
exactly.
Yeah,
that's the other thing. Like imagine if you're able to actually summon a monster or a goddess or whatever to fight with you. That would have been so fucking sick.
Dude, like
Not just like a cutscene that kills everyone, but like actually stand there and fight with you.
Granted, why the fuck were half of my summons the fucking Archeon, dude? Like, throwing a fucking boulder. I'm like, let me guess what he's gonna do. He's gonna pick up a fucking rock and throw it. And I'm just like, I'm so sick of this. Like, I have at least 3 summons right now. I'm always getting this fucking
exactly.
Dude. And,
I got the Leviathan so many times, it was like, come on.
Yeah.
Let me see a Titan real quick.
Let me see a fusion. Let me see, like, the Titan throwing the Leviathan.
I miss fucking Rama. I'm gonna use him again. Shit.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, and they just didn't fucking explain shit, because, like, when you go in, you're like, oh, Shiva's dead. What the fuck?
Yeah.
What's going on?
Yeah.
I know the Empire's trying to get to all the summons, all the gods and goddesses, but you're not explaining this.
Exactly. And there's, like... there's another video where the guy glitches out of the map during that part where you can see her head. right?
Mm-hmm.
Like her
on the side of the train tracks.
Yeah. I guess that's her, right?
Yeah. But then it's fucking Gentiana.
Yeah.
The whole fucking time.
But the thing is, like, is she that, or is that someone else, or is different Shiva? Because I don't know. Well, when he went out of the map in the video, you could actually see the whole body out there, which is crazy.
I don't know, dude. I don't get that either. Maybe it was just like a Sub-Zero ice clone.
Yeah.
She's like, shh. And then she's like, shh. And then, like, goes behind Arden and is like, fuck up, Arden. Dude, that was that part was so dope.
Yeah.
But
Gentiana was sick, but
and, like,
what else?
Not to mention, she was hella fucking creepy. Did you see all the photos?
Oh,
she was
dude!
I was like, that looks like Gentiana.
Yeah.
Like, fuck it is! Like, she, get out of here!
Fucking
like,
grunge.
Oh my gosh, she got the fucking long hair and
yeah.
She's fucking blind, and you're just like, what the hell?
I saved all those photos. I
oh yeah, those photos were hilarious. Because she's just nonchalant, just in the back.
Yeah.
Like, you're not gonna tell us you're here?
Oh my god.
You're going through the pictures and you're just like, what the fuck?
Okay, and the summon, what else is there? Oh yeah, Titan. Titan battle is fucking clunky.
I didn't know what the fuck to do.
Yeah, what are you hitting his hand?
I'm like, okay, am I hitting his hand or killing the Empire? Who's the enemy here? I'm like, Edward's Titan, sorry. Like, what's going on? I'm trying to help you, but I'm trying to help me, like. they're fucking, like, fucking sticking metal dicks in him, like, all over the place. And he's just, like, swinging at me.
Yeah.
I'm like, swing at them. I'm the chosen one, bitch.
Oh my gosh.
And you find out, like, your girlfriend talked to him, so he shouldn't have been angry with you.
Yeah.
But you're like, who else wears all black in this fucking game? Gosh.
Oh my goodness. Like, I feel like they wanted it to be something like God of War type, where it would have been a sick battle like God of War, like Kratos,
yeah.
Remember Kratos?
Yeah.
I think that's what they're trying to go for, something like that, but it was just fucking close.
And so I played that whole battle just to fucking injure his hand.
Yeah.
And then it's like, I absorb him, but then the Empire, I don't know if you listen to the radio, but the Empire takes credit for killing the Titan, and you're just like, I was fucking there, dude. Like, you guys didn't do shit. And then, what's another thing? Oh, the fucking commander, dude. The short-haired dude that is the friends of the father of King Regis.
Kor?
Yeah.
The Marshal?
Yeah, the Marshal. Oh. Like, when he... I wish he played a bigger part. He was like fucking Auron.
Yeah.
Comes in one mission.
Yeah.
And you're like, shows up at the end of the game or like near the, like when you're going to Altitia and you're just like,
yeah.
Dude, like, fuck you. You could have helped us win this quick. He's like, I'm scouting. I'm like, what? I'm the one taking all these fucking bases.
Exactly. Oh my gosh.
I don't know, but yeah. And
yeah, speaking of Altitia. There was nothing to do there. I was like,
I spent like 3 hours in that fucking Coliseum, dude.
Really?
Yeah. And
wait.
I still don't have a lot of money.
Wait, there's a Coliseum in Altitia?
You can bet on animals and find them and you get these fucking big ass prizes.
What?
You didn't fucking know that?
No.
Oh my gosh, David, you haven't even played the fucking game.
Wait, it's the Italy, right?
Yeah, the Italy, you go, there's a specific gondola that, oh, that's another fucking fun part. Gondola! That part was so fucking funny when he says that. But yeah, there's a specific one that goes straight to the middle of the Colosseum. You see it on the map.
Huh.
And then you go in there.
You get on the little boat thing?
Yeah, you just go to the guy and he takes you right in.
Oh, shit.
And,
I gotta do that.
But yeah, and so you can spend your money, you buy tokens, and then you bet the tokens. It's like playing, like it's like gambling. You bet on like different monster groups, and depending, it's so interesting. And you just have a fight out, and if your monster group wins, you get that you get the odds. So times four what you bet or whatever. And like if you get all the way up to like 1,000,000, you can buy like engine parts. You can buy like car parts. You can buy like weapons, gear.
Oh, shit.
Yeah,
what the fuck?
It's crazy. Like, did you get to the max score on Justice Monsters 5?
No, but yeah.
I got dude, I got the item that you get for getting that far, and it gives you like 30% resistance to all elements.
Oh shoot.
Yeah. So like I got that. Yeah. So yeah, I did a lot of that fucking minigame shit. The Colosseum one's annoying because it's a game of chance.
Did it even show the fighting or?
Yeah, it shows it. Yeah, they all are behind gates like in fucking Gladiator.
Okay.
And then they lift them up and they fight like fucking lions. That's all pretty of them. Cool. Yeah, that was a nice touch. But you're right. There's nothing to do in that city.
Yeah, that's why I didn't do anything.
Did you do the fucking monster hunts in the city? In Alticia?
Oh, they have some.
They do. Yes, you talk to the guy, the black dude, the black bartender.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he gives them. It's literally just an alleyway you go in and you fight like one monster.
That's the only one he gives you?
It's so stupid!
That's the only one he
gives you? No, he gives you like five of them like that.
Oh.
and it's just one of them is like the big ass blob. And you're just like, oh fuck, dude. Fucking demon jelly. That's what Cadence calls it. Demon jelly.
Yeah, because the moment that whole story segment, I thought there was nothing to do there. That's why I just left and like, okay, bye.
Yeah, no, I did the same thing. I didn't figure that out until I went back, like, right before I ended the game, because I'm like, I wonder if I'm missing anything. Turns out, even after being in the game, I missed hella shit, and I'm just like, it's because you don't fucking explain anything, like, you don't,
Speaking of the resistance shit, like, for gears, I didn't use any of those resistance shit.
Resistance?
Like, the resistance to fire, resistance
Oh, yeah, yeah, no.
You don't need to use any of that, because...
The only reason I used the one that I got at the Justice Monsters 5 thing is because I needed the dark resistance from the fucking, going into fucking dungeons. There's still two dungeons I need to go through. Not to mention, like, the hidden dungeons.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, I don't...
I was wondering, like, how do you get all the royal arms? Like, how did you get the Ultimate Blade or whatever?
The Ultimate Blade's not Ultimate Arm. Sid does it. You have to get an item for Sid. And then Sid will upgrade it. Ultimate Blade is dope, though. It has, like... Because it absorbs the energy, because it's still the engine blade. But, yeah, that one's one of the higher damage ones. I like that one just because you can wreck shit and not spend your health on a royal arm.
Yeah.
That was another mechanic I was getting pissed off.
Yeah, that's another thing. Why the fuck do you lose health using
low level, too? Yeah. You'll swing once with the fucking, like, axe, and you'll, like, die.
Like, why not use the MP for that?
Right?
It doesn't make any sense.
You don't fucking use the MP for anything.
Exactly.
Except when you get the fucking ring for three missions.
Fuck. Yeah, the only thing he used it for was to warp.
I almost half expected him to pull a fucking wooden sword out of his pocket when he didn't have any weapons on him. Like fucking Sora in Kingdom Hearts.
So to warp and to like use the state, or not, the dodge. Those are like the only things to use it for. Yeah, so fucking the magic system was bullshit too. Oh my god.
I got to a point where I stopped making spells.
I was so annoyed.
Because I was like, yes, they're effective, but, dude, like, it's like, if you make the wrong one, or you use the wrong one, you're just like, it damages your team?
Oh, yeah, it always damages your
team. Fuck, dude, I'm like, get out of the fucking way! Out of the fucking way! I'm casting a blizzard right now, bitch! Put a fucking coat on or something.
Shit! That's the other bullshit mechanic. Like, I'm always hurting my friends.
You're like, oh, I'm gonna give it to this fucking bitch right now. And then you put a fucking fire spell down, and everyone's like,
Exactly. Like, and what the fuck?
I'm just like,
how do you do this?
When I first did that, I was like, I was not expecting this.
Yeah. And after how many times, he was like, okay, you guys are going to get
this. They should have made this turn-based, so you guys all stand beside me.
Exactly. Like, what the fuck? Every time you should scash that, because you know how Noctis dodges?
Yeah.
If you're close, he always dodges. Everyone should do that. Everyone should dodge. Oh my gosh.
Oh, they're
always
man.
Doing friendly fire. You know?
I know, and the...
I'm like, oh my...
It fucking looks like, especially when you cast like Blizzard, it looks like a fucking nuclear fallout because they're all like walking around like, what the fuck just happened?
Yeah,
and they're all holding themselves.
It was like that sausage party scene. Do you have
yeah.
Gosh, anybody using Thundergo or whatever? They're all getting electrocuted.
Yeah, and their clothes afterwards are just like fucking fried.
Yeah, they're all fried. Their faces all black.
And I'm just like, we are not coordinated at all.
Oh my gosh.
Gosh, man.
Oh, why did that thing? Any way to fix
that? It cracks me up when you do a fucking link attack or a blindside and it fucking misses.
That's happened so many times.
The ones that are really fancy where you like jump up in the air or like you grab Pronto's gun. Yeah. And it's just like, shit. Did you try the gun on Noctis?
Yeah.
It's fucking stupid. Like, looks like you're shooting BBs at the fucking monster. It's like bouncing off of them.
Where's my assault rifle? Shit. That's the other thing. Is like, I feel like there's a good amount of like weapons you could choose from, but you could never like specialize in them.
Yeah, I know.
Like you don't. Oh god, should've been a thing where if you want to be a gun wielder, there should've been a way to like
give you abilities to use the gun instead of just fire.
Exactly.
Like what the
there's
fuck?
There's no skills for that. Like the combat. Yeah, the session combat tree thingy.
Yeah.
First time I thought there was like one for each like weapon.
Right? Yeah, I thought that would have made more sense, or like each weapon type at least.
Exactly. Right? Yeah. So you could like build up towards your the way you
like
want.
Something that would make him strong enough to wield the heavy blades quicker. You
exactly.
Know, faster swings.
Exactly. Like you could specialize on a certain class. Like
I.
You could maybe run through the game with guns if you want to.
Yes.
That would have been sick. Oh my goodness.
Outfits. Can we talk about fucking outfits? What? So if you didn't pre-order certain things, you wouldn't have had certain outfits?
Yeah.
What? Why do I have this fucking K-pop hipster outfit that gives me extra strength?
Yeah.
Why? Why that one?
And why was there no more after those? Like,
except why can't I buy outfits? Why can't I spend my money on something aesthetic?
Exactly.
Instead of fucking gay ass flames on my car, like what the fuck? Oh yeah, I'm really gonna put these decals on my car. Hammerhead right on the windshield.
Yeah, fuck that.
Like, gosh, I mean, some of the colors for the cars are really cool, but other than that, I was like, that was a wasted like experience. Like,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, like you couldn't buy any more outfits, which that's another thing that felt like it was half-assed. Like, they just put that
in. That was like, pre-order. We gotta get people to pre-order this. Add outfits. put attributes on them, too.
Exactly. Like,
that'll make them more desirable.
Sometimes I want to use something, but it reduces my...
I use the one that that kept your stamina at 100% all the time. Mm, that was the one I used mainly. Because, like, that mountain I was telling you about with the bird, it wastes your stamina. If you run, you could just run straight up the mountain because it doesn't waste your fucking stamina.
Nice.
Because he moves really slow. He's, like, really climbing, like, with his feet and stuff. Mm. Other than that, I don't know. We can get to the story now unless you got anything else to say. I'm trying to think of any other mechanics that pissed me off. there was this one part of the map that really pissed me off where it looked like you and the Chocobo could have jumped over and taken a shortcut through the road. This is on the road to... Golden Key. It's one of those roads, and it like you have to go all the way around this like mountain face to the road.
Yeah.
But you can look at the top of it. Like there's planes on top of it. And you're like, oh, I should be able to just jump. So I tried with the Chocobo, fucking boundary, and it's like that pissed me off so much because I could have saved so much time than having to run all the way around. Because I would park my car strategically at different areas, so I could just move back to fast travel to the car. If I wanted to go back to complete a mission, and I would just take the Chocobo out to the mission half the time, but like
I did the same thing with one of the bases, like, because I guess you're supposed to go to the Vantage. But I tried to jump with the Chocobo above the fence. It's like I was gonna make it, but there's a boundary
there. Yeah, dude, that's the worst. It's like
stupid.
Irenaea was kind of weird, like.
Oh, yeah, I never got her story real well. Like,
did you ever experience when she comes and helps you on the battlefield?
No. What?
She'll do that randomly.
What?
She'll come with her dropship and come in and fucking help
sick.
Your ass. Yeah, that was dope.
What the fuck?
But my game glitched when that happened. So it was like she spoke and said, oh, I'm coming to help you guys. And her ship just stayed there for like dude, I ran away. I came back. It was still stuck in the map above there. I think it's because I might have killed the enemy right when she said that.
Okay.
So it was like you didn't know what the fuck to do. And it's a red dropship, so it looks different than the other ones.
Yeah.
What about the scaling, the enemy like level scaling? Like, you know how like in the beginning you're fighting like the swordsmen and the gunmen or whatever, the magic type people.
Oh, yeah.
And then the assassins are fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Do crazy damage. I thought that the scaling was good for them.
Yeah.
Throughout the game. Like as you complete the story or as you level up, I don't know how that mechanic works, but that was really good. The fucking demons in the dungeons are nuts.
Oh, yeah.
The Ronin. Those ones are pretty cool. I like their design a lot.
Yeah. There's that Reaper, too. That was pretty cool.
Yeah, yeah. Like, the Necromancers look pretty dope. Do you remember the scene when you're running back after being wherever the fuck that stone prison was for, what, fucking 50 years or something? 30 years? I don't know. Shit.
Yeah.
Like, I'm like, okay, whatever. What are you meditating? Like, I don't understand, like... Not to mention that fucking facial hair is pathetic. Shit, you can't even fucking grow a beard like your dad. You're pathetic.
Oh yeah, the Yojimbo, is that what you're gonna tell? Or is it called the Yojimbo?
No, yeah, that's one of them. But I'm talking about like that scene was dope where you're running back and there's fucking demons everywhere.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I was hoping that you wouldn't get picked up. I was hoping you'd have to fight your ass all the way back.
Yeah, exactly.
That would have been so much cooler than like that kid like. Oh, Prince Noctis, let me save you in my pickup truck.
Yeah, I was ready to...
Oh, I was like, oh, this is going to be good.
Exactly.
I'm about to level up.
Yeah, exactly. I was ready
to... I was like, I need to get some levels.
Exactly. And I thought that was funny when you're driving back, there's just monsters on the road, like, okay, we're just going to drive by you guys.
Yeah.
You guys aren't going to hurt us.
Yeah.
There's literally this scene where, like, you're turning the corner, and there are fucking enemies all right in front of you, and they don't do shit. Like, come on.
Yeah, it was...
That's hilarious.
It was a totally different game at the end of it. Like, it was interesting.
So, what? Story?
Story.
Fucking garbage.
Like, okay, this gets back... Let's get back to this multimedia thing. So, if you didn't watch the anime or Kingsglaive...
Yeah.
You have no idea what the fucking context is at the beginning of the game.
Yeah.
No fucking idea. And don't even expect them to explain the context. Because they won't. They'll give you a fucking 5-minute silent cutscene with scenes from Kingsglaive and expect you to know what the fuck's going on.
Exactly.
No words.
You shouldn't have.
Like, you couldn't afford to get the licensing to put the dialogue from the movie in the game?
Oh my god.
Like, I don't. Yeah,
before we get to stories, like, Versus 13, I think for me, the reason why I was so hyped for Versus 13 was because. Of the story, well, it looked like it was gonna be something like Romeo and Juliet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, I remember you talking to me about that.
Yeah.
Originally, way back.
That's exactly what I was hoping for because I would have loved to see that happen, but this is what we get. Nothing, none of that. All that shit was cut.
And yeah.
So what happened?
So the reason it fell flat was because. They did not deliver it. They did not deliver it great. They did not deliver it in a very understandable way.
Yeah.
The fact that anyone had any questions at the end of the game is like, I can understand there being debate about the ending. Like, is he alive? Is he dead?
Yeah.
You know, are they both alive? Are they both dead? Are they gods? Is she a goddess? Like, whatever.
Yeah.
Like, you know, because they do that whole thing where they alter the logo at the end.
Yeah.
Like, okay.
Fuck you guys for altering the logo.
Yeah. It's like, yeah, I don't want no fucking Noctis in my logo.
I was gonna get that tattoo, too. Fuck.
I was like, shit.
I gotta add this guy here.
Hey, can you mod this, bro? I need an extra god. I can understand debate, and I think they did that on purpose, so there would be, like, some open-ended debate.
Mm.
But it didn't make up for the rest of the story just being, like...
I'm trying to remember... Oh, yeah. I'm trying to remember why. How did the night thing, whole thing happen again?
Night.
Like, why was it just night for like 10 years?
Oh, remember they said the days were growing darker and darker.
Yeah,
quicker
why
and quicker?
Did that happen?
Because something to do with the crystal Mm-hmm. And something to do about it being in the wrong hands, or there being like it, the basically there being darkness in the realm or whatever, being the demonic presence or whatever. Mm. Somehow, like, it wouldn't have been remedied until Noctis completed his task.
Okay.
So that was part of the prophecy, I think. They don't explain the prophecy too well. You can kind of guess at it as Luna's doing her thing, and like you see the frustration between the Empire and Ravis, like, and how he's like, how like Arden is like telling Ravis, like, you know the price she has to pay to summon the gods.
Yeah.
So you know, like, Luna, something bad's gonna happen to Luna. I fucking called it. I knew she was gonna fucking die. She got fucking shivved. And
shivved.
And Arden was, I thought Arden was a cool character, but it was like, I didn't expect it to center on him at the end.
Yeah.
I didn't expect him to be the ultimate
exactly
boss.
I felt like it was too easy for him too.
Yeah, you know, it was like, I liked how maniacal he was and how like joking he was, but he almost seemed like he was the really neutral guy.
Mm-hmm.
They did a good job of concealing like him being like a total asshole.
Yeah.
But, I was mad that there was no interaction with Ravis.
Yeah.
I was mad that there was no fight, no cutscene, nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing between Noctis and Ravis. I was pissed off about that.
Ravis is the brother?
Yeah.
Yeah. Speaking of like cutscenes, yeah. There are three, four maybe cutscenes throughout the whole
game. Oh, yeah.
Like CG cutscenes.
Right. And I'm like,
oh,
is this
God.
A fucking Square Enix game or
exactly.
What?
Exactly. Where are my CG cutscenes?
Gosh, man. They might as well been Infamous 1. Shit. Might as well fucking draw the cutscenes.
Fuck.
That's
a good one. Infamous. But that was a better combat, though.
Thundaga.
But yeah, what about CG cutscenes? I fucking love CG cutscenes.
Yeah, I know.
I don't care what anyone says.
Well, especially after doing Kingsglaive.
Yeah.
Don't follow up with a game that has no beautiful,
yeah,
you know, cutscenes. And different ones, too.
Yeah, no.
I was pissed. I thought it was such a cop-out to use a Kingsglaive.
Exactly.
Game.
I hated that boy.
I was like, you guys... 10 years! What? You're like, oh, we made a movie. Let's just make the best of it. Let's recycle this material. You know, we want people who haven't seen the movie to want to see the movie. So
yeah.
Let's do a little promotion here. They should have had a fucking, like, Kingsglaive, like, 2016.
That was so sad.
They should have had the end of that cutscene. They should have had out now on Blu-ray.
Yeah. It only the cutscene, the way they even put it in the game, felt like it was a promotional.
It did, and
yeah, because there's no audio or anything.
No fucking audio, and I was like so pissed when I saw it. I honestly I didn't even pay attention to it because I was like, are you fucking serious?
Yeah.
Like, like you don't because the thing that pissed me off was like, I know there are people who are playing this game who have not watched Kingsglaive.
Yeah,
and they did not. They wouldn't understand even watching that.
Yeah.
They'd be left with questions like, "Who's that?
Yeah.
Who's that?
Exactly.
Why? What's this room?
Yeah.
Where are they at right now?
Exactly.
You know, no one knows. They're, you know, the only thing that gave it away was the fucking dome being like split.
Yeah.
But you really, really have to pay attention to what the every single dialogue to know what exactly is going on. I had to listen to the radio broadcast. They tell you a lot, like about the context.
That's annoying.
I'm like, dude, like, this is requiring too much of me to understand.
Exactly.
This game.
Exactly.
Like, do you have, like, are you guys writing a book, too, that we need to read in order to, like, understand what we just played?
Gosh.
The sequel on bookshelves now.
Get it on the Kindle.
Gosh.
Fudge.
Yeah, so I just thought that there. What do you call that? You call that? It was just disjointed. It was just
exactly.
It was disjointed. It didn't consider the fact that people aren't going to watch all of your multimedia stuff.
Yeah.
As much as you try to promote it, you know, a lot of fans just wanted an experience that was really just going to blow their minds. I think that the. it was completely different Final Fantasy experience.
Yeah.
But it was almost to the point where it was like almost not a Final Fantasy at the same time. I was thinking about that today. I was like, could you even... It's like, I know you need to do stuff, things new. You need to shake it up a little bit. But shit, like, it didn't deliver the narrative and the plot that... Even the Final Fantasies that sucked dick, like, you still knew what was going on. Mm-hmm. You still understood the story, and they still told it in incompletion.
Yeah.
13's always the example. Like, and I never played 13, but I've listened to the story. I've listened to people explain to me the story, and they can do it from beginning to end. I don't think someone can do this like that. They'd be like, well, they kind of fucked this part up, you know?
That's what I was trying to... When it's like, I'm trying to remember how the story goes. It's like,
so basically, the Empire is like invading. The Empire has totally bodied Niflheim. Mm-hmm. Wait, no.
Or
Lucis.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. So Niflheim has totally bodied Lucis because they're fucking messing with these demonic power, but no one like knows that on the surface.
And this is all happening while...
While Noctis is a boy and growing up, basically.
Yeah.
And then when he leaves to go on his little... What do they call it? His tour or whatever. It's weird, that whole thing. Because I guess his dad did the same shit when he was a kid. But, like... That's when shit hits the fan. And so Noctis, knowing he's been groomed to fulfill the prophecy, because he's the chosen one, has to go through this game knowing that he has to fucking give up his life, basically. But we don't really become fully aware of that until the end of the game.
Yeah.
But we know...
He's just going to marry Luna for...
Yeah, he thinks that he's just going to go marry Luna for political reasons, to strengthen the bond between, you know what I'm talking about, Lucis and whatever the fucking little territory is. Can't fucking remember. That's my phone. It's probably dying. Tenebrae.
Yeah.
There you go. And so that once there's no more Lucis, they fucking like wrecked the Crown City.
Yeah.
No more Lucis. No more marriage because there's no power there anymore.
Yeah.
They got the fucking crystal too.
Yeah.
Luna's got the ring. Noctis. Now Noctis's main mission is, I need to get the fucking ring. And if Bae's still alive, need to marry her because I actually do love her, I guess. Like, yeah. And that's really his attitude, like, yeah, whatever. I guess we'll have a wedding if there's time. Like, Prompto will be the photographer. That's it. And then, so then she gets killed and he's like, fuck, I'm going to be a virgin for life.
Good shit.
And I'm like, and at that point I've been like, I'm getting with Gladio's sister.
Yeah, exactly.
And then basically the rest of the journey is just him accepting the fact that I have to lay down my life. And I think that's why the drama didn't make any sense. That's why when Gladio was pissed off at Noctis, I didn't understand why he was like, you need to grow the fuck up, Noctis.
I didn't get that part either.
And then I finally understood that everyone at that party knew he had to die.
Mm.
The whole time.
Okay.
Everyone knew he had to give up his life.
That makes sense.
So Gladio was getting sick of his fucking attitude and nonchalant ways, knowing he needed to man up and be like, I gotta step to this.
Yeah.
I gotta go get the crystal so I can complete my mission.
Right.
Which is weird, which is a tough... That was the hardest... That was one of the most touching parts of the games, was the bond between the four people, the bond between the guys, and knowing that he has to die, knowing that he has to give up his life and he won't be back with them, but having to encourage him to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Because of what King Regis kind of like knows, like that's the only way that you're gonna save their universe, their world, basically.
Yeah, and we were talking about it earlier, where the death of Luna wasn't like as significant. Because there was such a disconnection throughout the game, where the way they told the story, there's not enough cutscenes, obviously.
Yes.
So
you don't see Luna that much.
Yeah, you don't see her that there, because they cut a shit ton of cutscenes from the beginning, from the game. So when she died, it's like, okay.
And then there was that weird ass cutscene where she's helping the villagers healing the villagers.
Oh, yeah.
That just came out of nowhere after the Titan, I think, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And you're just like, where the fuck did this go from? And then you're expecting more of that to, like, kind of build up to meeting her.
Yeah.
Nothing until you go to Alticia.
Exactly.
And then you see her and you're like, oh, psh! And he just gets fucking stabbed and you're like, fuck, man. Can a guy get laid around here? Like, shit.
Yeah, so the story was just... It was hard to get emotional at all because...
It was, because there was no investment in that character because you just didn't see her, and it was like they were playing tag the whole game, but you never, like, caught up to her. Exactly. Umbra was the only connection they had with one another.
Yeah.
Journal. Don't we have fucking cell phones? What? You guys don't believe in calling each other? No, hey, babe. How's your day going?
That's bad luck.
Oh, no. Let me write in this old-ass journal and, like, pass it back and forth between my time-traveling dog, who can't go back in time and save my life after I've been stabbed.
You can't call your up, right? So after that, what happens?
Then the whole...
Person, the train. And then they go on the train.
Yeah, the train. And it's like...
It lasts for, like... Stupid.
You go to these, like, tiny-ass little sections.
Yeah.
I'm, like, scouring every part of this train to see if there's anything to pick up. God.
Yeah. They actually have shit to pick up.
They do, yeah.
Surprisingly. They have,
like, when you walk all the way down the tracks, there's a fucking glowing thing. I'm like, wow, you know what? And I did it for Shits and Giggles. I'm like, I know there's a fucking shit down here. It's a fucking Final Fantasy game.
Yeah.
There's always shit at the end of the boundary. And I go down there, and sure enough, there's a fucking glowing blue thing down there. I'm like, fuck. Give my ether.
See, I guess that was somewhat of a good thing that they actually put stuff there. Because if you just walk down the whole
train, fucking there's trolling you
over there. Like, really?
Just trolling.
Basically, everywhere throughout the end of the map, there was something to pick up.
Yeah.
Which is, I guess, good. That's a good thing.
It's good. It's good that you were able to satisfy one of our hopes.
Yeah.
But
yeah, those train chapters went by super quick.
Dude, what was it like? Isn't it like a... It's after you get out of... No, actually, it's... Damn, you're right. It's like 11 to 14, right?
Or 11 to... It's like 10, 11, 12, something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, it's... And it's like... Yeah, there's not much to do. Like, one of them, you go to Tenebrae. You don't even get to go up to the fucking manor or the castle.
Yeah.
You go to a... Outlook, an overlook of the castle, talk to one of the maids, that's it. And then you go back to the fucking train, that's it.
Yeah.
And you're like, that's the chapter? Like, that's the... One of them is the Shiva one. All that is defeat all the enemies and go to a cutscene with Arden.
Exactly.
What? You call that a chapter?
Yeah, they should have had...
The train... Every sequence in the train should have been one chapter.
Exactly.
The whole thing should have been one chapter.
Exactly. That whole train thing should have been one chapter.
They needed 15 chapters.
Yeah.
That's why they did that. They're like, we gotta save face. We need it to match the title. Alright. Take a shit, that's a chapter.
Oh my gosh. The thing that was really... Another really disappointing thing is... You know when you got on top of the train and like... You're about to fight this fucking...
Oh, yeah, and when he goes into the tunnel?
Well, like, no, where, they're trying to invade you or something like that.
Yeah.
The flying things.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was gonna be sick, but it was like 2 minutes.
Right?
I was like, what?
Yeah, and I know, and you, of all people, you're the train guy here. You're the train sequence fan.
That was the fucking... That should have been one of the highlights, and it lasted... All you have to do is teleport from one to one and like blow them up and oh my
god.
Really? That shit should have been amazing. That was so disappointing.
Yeah, that's why they should have had a gun skill tree. You could just fucking Nathan Drake that shit.
Exactly.
Give him my scope, bitch.
Oh, that was so disappointing. Shit.
Oh, yeah, I know. It was like, I don't know.
Like, that could have made up for the lack of invasion of the... Lucius, but nah.
You want to know?
It fucked it up.
You want to know what one of my coworkers told me? He said, this game reminds me of what a new studio would produce.
Nice.
If you were like a brand new studio and like you were trying something new, this is the kind of game you'd have where you'd have like, you know, unrefined aspects of it.
Mm.
But from a studio like Square Enix.
Yeah.
Final Fantasy was the first RPG, the first video game RPG ever. Like, that's, like, historic. And for them to not... Granted, I know times are changing and they're trying to do stuff new, but...
Yeah. Ariana Grande.
They should have taken... They should have at least taken another year.
Yeah.
If they needed it.
Yeah.
But they were... They knew... The people were already getting sick of their shit because it's been so long.
And they kept announcing dates, too. Like, they should
have... Oh, man. When they delayed it that last time, I was like, you guys are fucking unbelievable. Because it made a big... They made an event for the fucking announcement day. And then they changed it. Like, I don't get this. Oh, gosh. God. Oh, we said... Oh, we said... What was it original? October?
September? September 29th or 30th, something like that. It's funny because remember how they had the roulette on November 30th?
Yes!
And it
like Freudian slip, dude. Freudian slip. They're just like, that's what you really meant.
Stupid.
Like, shit. Like, that was crazy. Like, and, yeah, so the ending.
Oh, yeah, chapter 13. That was a big deal for a lot of people, actually. It's when... You're in the mech dungeon shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You can't sprint, and you're like, you have no weapons. And
yeah.
What'd you think about that shit?
When you first get the ring, when you put the ring on,
or just that whole chapter, like without the ring and then gets
fucking hella long.
Yeah.
And boring.
Yeah.
And I thought that the mechs were gonna be way more frightening than they were.
Yeah.
There was that one jump scare where you're walking and it grabs your leg or whatever.
Yeah.
That was cool.
Yeah.
It had a kind of... They tried to go for this kind of, like, Dead Space feel to it.
I could see why... I could appreciate them trying to, like, add a different element.
Yeah. And I thought, that's cool, but...
It was too long. And it wasn't...
Walking... Because there were times where you have to backtrack a lot. And I'm just like, shit, man, this is... I just wasn't ready for that. I was ready for just, like, kind of go.
Yeah.
It's like, how many fucking elevators do I have to power up? How many damn buttons do I have to hit? Yeah. Like, oh, and they're like, oh, do you want to sleep? No, there's fucking 7 bunks in this place.
Exactly.
Why do I need to sleep every 5 minutes? Shit. Because you should be high enough level already to where even when one of those guys explodes on you, it doesn't take that much health off of you.
Yeah.
And there's a fucking outfit for that. Just put the health outfit on and run through that bitch. Like, I just I don't know. I don't know. The kill ability on the ring. Oh my gosh. I was like, this is stupid. I think it'd be more fascinating to use your fucking fist, not this. Like, I was like, cool. Oh yeah, we're fucking fist fighting now,
that
bitch.
That would be actually cool to use fists. Fisticuffs.
Yeah. He, like, takes off, like... He, like, fashions, like, brass knuckles out of the fucking Magitex. Just like, let's do this.
Dead Rising.
Dude takes off his shirt.
That would be cool.
Yeah, he already looks like fucking... what's his name? Jin from Tekken.
It had other abilities, too, where you could, like... What is the gravity shit...
Yeah, I used that one on the demon. But there was one demon that kept respawning.
Yeah, the big...
What the big fuck one? Was that? Yeah. I killed that bitch 3 times. And you're like walking away. And you're not even looking at him, but you hear this like...
Yeah, exactly. I was so pissed.
I'm like, no fucking way.
I was like, come on.
This has to be a problem.
I was like, I felt such a badass when I killed that fucker with one hit.
Yeah, I was like, yeah!
And they're like, you can hear that.
I'm like,
I hate that fucking sound, too.
I felt like a fucking toilet flushing. Like,
oh my gosh.
And then,
Yeah, it was annoying.
I don't know.
The parry is cool, though, but that took away your MP in like a second.
Yeah! Oh, I should have been building MP this whole
Exactly.
I've never seen that bar before.
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
The only time I ever depleted that bar was when I fucking teleported like 100 times in a row.
Oh my gosh.
And then...
Fuck.
And then... Dude, the fucking Prompto reveal? Oh, shit.
I was kind of confused there, too. Like,
I'm a Smith. Because I always wonder, like, dude, that's a fucking gay-ass tattoo you have.
Yeah.
Fucking barcode.
I can see that.
Like, what are you, Hitman? Shit.
So, what? He was one of what?
He was, like... If I'm to understand this correctly, he's like a test tube baby, and he's got like demon like DNA in his blood. Yeah. So he was like, he's basically born in Niflheim, but like a citizen of Lucis, basically born like raised in Lucis, I suppose.
Which is kind of weird because there was no hint of that at all in the.
No, and that's why I'm like. Why are you trying to make this more interesting at this point?
Yeah.
You have so much fucking explaining to do.
Yeah.
You don't need to add this other plot twist.
Yeah.
Because it did nothing. It did nothing for the story.
Exactly.
And it's like, because how do they solve it? Oh, pal, that's all right.
Exactly.
You're one of us, buddy.
Exactly.
Why even go through that then?
Yeah. That whole cutscene, I was like, yeah, they're not going to do anything.
You like go in the throne room, you're like, oh, shit, am I going to get a cool weapon or something? No, there's a fucking, like, chest behind the throne room or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Like, cool. Can I get his cape at least?
Yeah, that's the thing. Is like, they never showed that guy. Like, he turned into a demon?
He was that demon you had to fight at the end. The one that kept following you around and you couldn't kill at first.
Oh, the one that kept, like,
flying?
Oh,
yeah,
that's
him. Yeah. Oh,
okay.
And then he goes, and when you actually do get to fight him, he goes down like a fucking chump.
Yeah. Fuck.
It's like, gosh.
Yeah, not enough cutscene with that guy either. Like, what the fudge? Where did he go?
And then, like, I thought that was a funny twist when you, like, get to the crystal and you're just like, Bahamut's, like, the dude.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, whatever. I'm like, Bahamut, why can't you kill this guy? Why do I gotta kill him?
Exactly.
You're fucking badass,
fucking
dude.
Bahamut, dude. Can you summon him after the game?
I don't know. I think you should be able to.
Yeah.
There's so much... There's so much they should have refined. Like,
yes.
I just...
So he went in the crystal.
For, like, what? Ten years?
Yeah.
And
he wakes up in that, yeah, that little prison thing you're talking about.
Yeah, which I... That
which
was...
Which is weird.
I didn't fucking understand that well.
Yeah, I don't know what happened to the crystal. It just disappeared, I guess. How do you just wake up there? And it wasn't even that far away from everyone else, I felt like. Like, you guys could have searched for him? I don't know. I guess it was hard to find, but still, like, he wasn't that far away. He wasn't some crazy, out of the world.
Yeah,
shit.
I know. I.
He was just right there the whole time for 10 years. And I can't even imagine that being night for 10 years like that. That's nuts.
Yeah, man.
But yeah, so he, what was it,
and we're supposed to understand after 10 years, that's the only facial hair he can grow.
Yeah.
10 years of facial hair?
You know,
and you look like a fucking 14-year-old boy? Like, shit.
I thought that was the ride back with the kid. I thought that was kind of cool to hear what happened.
Yeah.
That was kind of cool.
That was interesting. Yeah.
Yeah. But... Fucking Noctis, I feel like his head was a little too big when he was older.
His head
looked a little too big for his body for some reason, which is weird. I mean, I don't know if that's normal, but... I don't know. But it looked weird. And then, fucking when you get reunited with your allies, I laughed because they're... After 10 years, they're wearing the same fucking clothes. Like, what the... Well, you guys gonna change clothes?
Speaking of fucking clothes, though, fucking, like, Noctis, like, where does he get this fucking royal raiment?
Yeah.
That he's wearing? That didn't make sense, but whatever, it's a fucking video game. I guess not everything has to make sense, but, man, like, I don't know. There was no Cindy at the end, either.
Oh, yeah, I wanted to fucking see what she looked like.
I thought she lived there, like, still. Oh, no, they live in Alticia, don't they? Not Alticia, but, Lestalum.
I don't know, I thought they were in Hammerhead. But
I don't know, dude.
I guess the garage was still there, but not them.
I just hate how fucking nonchalant they are when they're reunited with Noctis.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it took you long enough.
10 years.
Yeah, fuck you, Gladio. Let down your guard. Love me.
Yeah, like, Oh, I really wanted to see Cindy. I was so excited to see her. I bet she'd have been still hot.
Oh, hell yeah.
Even hotter, actually. I wanted to see old man fucking Sid.
Oh, yeah.
Like 9 years old or something. I don't know. 80, maybe. So, yeah. Basically, when I got to that point, I was like, I'm going to fucking finish this game now. Because there's no more...
There was nothing else to do. You can't even leave Hammerhead without ending the game.
Yeah.
I think you can talk to Umbra, maybe.
Yeah, you could still do that, but it was just...
I was done. Yeah. I was really, like, even all the good parts of the non-story game, I was just like, finish him.
Exactly.
And I was just like... And then
it just started to drag a little
bit. You get to the last thing, and you're expecting, like, okay, let's draw out this walk to the final boss, like I said. Fucking, like... You walk, you kill some enemies, go on a subway, come out the subway, there's the fucking steps to the throne room.
There are actually some hard boss or enemies in the city.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. Like, there's a alleyway where there are like two of those snake thingies.
Oh, yeah, yeah. They're
pretty hard. And there's that thingamajig, I don't know what it was. It wasn't like a behemoth, but it shot like a fucking laser.
Yeah, yeah, I know what you're talking about.
But, yeah, that was about it. And then, I think after that, there was, like, a behemoth or something. There was something after that that went down, like, a chunk.
Yeah. And then, like, once you get past that part, the boss battles are easier than those battles.
Yeah. Yeah.
If, like, wow, cool, like, I can just teleport everywhere.
Yeah. And I think, okay, so for me, the highlight was definitely the Ifrit, because...
Oh, yeah.
That shit was fucking sick.
It was a cool-looking battle, yeah.
That was the coolest part of the game for me. It wasn't... I mean, the combat didn't make up for it. But
yeah.
It was still cool, because...
I thought it was really cool the way they made him look.
Yeah.
I thought his design was really
cool. Yeah, that was really cool. Like, the way he just popped up and he was just sitting on his chair.
Yeah.
That was sick. I mean, we saw that in the beginning of the
game,
but it was still sick. I guess, Arden just... took him or something, or why was he on his side?
I was wondering the same damn thing, because they hadn't had any luck with recruiting any of the gods up to that point. Basically, they made it seem like Ifrit on his own will was like, I fucking hate good guys.
Exactly, that's what it looked like.
Yeah.
He was just a bag effort or something. He's like Ares.
Yeah, I'm just here.
He's just Ares here. I just want to make war for no reason.
And so, yeah, that was really cool, but at the same time, I was just like, my battle with him didn't last too long.
Yeah.
Neither did my battle with Arden, to be honest with you. That didn't last long either.
Yeah, that was stupid.
I zoomed right through that damn battle.
So, Bahamut comes in. That was freaking sick.
Yeah, that was dope.
The sword comes down.
Yeah.
Oh, that was good. I love that part.
And I love, like, Ifrit's response. Doesn't he, like... Doesn't he dodge the sword and like run up it or something?
I forgot.
I can't remember. It was some dope animation.
I recorded all that shit.
Yeah, that was really cool.
Yeah, and then the way Shiva or Gentiana comes in, that was also really cool.
Yeah.
Now there were like a shit ton of them. I love that part. But then, how did he beat him? Oh yeah, he's still alive. Oh yeah, she kisses him, right? And that was it.
Yeah, and like you can
kiss
him. Supposedly could summon him. If you play post game, I'm assuming you can, which I really want to do to see what he looks like, what movesets he has.
That new game plus, was that added after as a patch?
Yeah, they've already added that, I believe.
So that wasn't in the initial launch, right? Because when I go into main menu, it says new game plus now.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, it wasn't. No, because I played it before. I beat the game before they added it, and you basically just load your game and you start at the map or whatever.
Because it's sending me the main menu. But yeah, the Ifrit part was a highlight for me. And then you go to Arden. Oh, and then when he had those bodies chained up, that was creepy.
Yeah, I thought that was the most twisted part of the game.
Yeah, but I guess they weren't the real bodies.
They were just illusions.
Yeah,
but that, like, they had fucking Luna.
Yeah, Regis.
I'm like, oh, shit, dude.
That was creepy.
This shit just got to a whole other level.
Yeah.
And then you fight him, and you're just like, this is just like the fucking Leviathan.
Exactly.
Copy and paste Leviathan.
Exactly.
You can throw shit back at me.
Exactly. That was fucking stupid. That Super Saiyan.
Oh god, sword lock! Tap, 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 tap!
Oh my gosh. Yeah. Man. What was before that? There was a. Yeah, you find the street and then like, it was like just normal for a little bit, and then you get to that Super Saiyan mode shit.
Yeah.
I don't know. It was just the Infinite Battle was way better than that.
I just hated how.
It was so easy too. Like
yes, that's my only issue. I liked the way it looked. I didn't mind that. It was just. I felt like I shouldn't have been so powerful.
Exactly. Like, I beat it, and you were like 65?
Yeah.
I was like 52 or 53, something like that.
Damn, and it was still easy.
Yeah, that's a problem right there. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, and I honestly, I couldn't believe how easy the bosses were in this game.
Yeah.
Damn. Granted, I was a kid when I beat Final Fantasy VII.
Yeah.
But still, like, that was turn-based, and that was fucking hard, dude. Shit, you would expect a live-action thing, it would be something like God of War-ish, you know, where they're not going to go down like jumps, you know? They do a lot of damage.
Exactly.
Let me use my potion. I think I used one potion last boss battle.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, that's the other thing is, like, speaking of potions, like,
iframes?
What do you mean?
Like, you, like, throw a potion up and you can't get hit?
Oh, yeah.
That's a mechanic. If they would have taken that out, that game would have been twice as hard.
Yeah. Even the whole technique shit. You were invulnerable.
Yeah, yeah.
In the techniques. But, yeah. Up to that point, at the end, there was a point where you picked up enough. Like, you didn't have to buy anything. You picked up enough potions and mega potions, mega elixirs. You didn't use all that. I didn't have to use any of that.
You want to know what I used all mine on? One of the fucking last dungeons that's hella hard.
Yeah.
I used them so many because bosses. There's a point in one of the dungeons where you fight four bosses at one time.
Nice.
And that's when I used all my fucking items. So I actually had, and I ended up having to buy some to go in the last one. But I didn't even end up needing any of it.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just like,
yeah, I was just surprised how I didn't have to use any of the mega, like, Mega Phoenix, Mega Elixir, whatever, Elixir.
Yeah.
Oh.
I
didn't die once. I don't think you died once at all for the game, right? Like, game over?
I didn't get one game over.
Yeah, there's something wrong if you don't get a game over in a Final Fantasy game.
Exactly,
What the fuck? Even just a game.
You know, I didn't rage once in this game.
Exactly.
This was a very happy game. I don't think that's healthy.
Exactly. You should be frustrated.
Yes. It's like, shit.
Give me a challenge.
Damn.
I don't know how to measure.
why did we die more in the latest Gauntlet game than this game?
Yeah, like, what? Yeah, there was never a sense of, like, frustration. There was never there at all. Oh, my goodness. There was never a wall that stops you in that game. Yeah, so the ending was, I guess, Arden got what he wanted, ultimately. Because I've been reading up in, there's still debates, but, like, I guess Arden got what he really wanted. Which was to end the bloodline and to kill him, to die?
Well, okay, so he was going to die regardless. As long as Noctis obeyed the prophecy, he was going to die regardless. And he didn't go out like a chump, which he didn't. But ending the bloodline, I honestly haven't even thought about that. But yeah, I guess in a sense, there can be no more Lucis royalty because the only shot that Noctis had at having a child was with Luna.
Yeah.
Ooh, that'd be some fan fiction. He gets Gladio's sister pregnant.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, but so yeah, so I think that Arden's at peace with it because he's the big bad guy or whatever, and like Noctis having died is that's the end of that monarchy, so now they go to a constitutional democracy.
Yeah, that's the other thing. Is like, if you want, if you're on artist side, I guess that was a good thing. He got what he wanted, right?
Yeah. Well, in a sense, I mean, no. Does anyone really want to die? That's the question. Yeah. If you, I mean, yeah, he may have fucked over the Lucian bloodline, but he dies. You know.
But isn't that what he wanted though? Because he was immortal, right?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, and he did complain about that one time. Yeah.
But I was, even though, yeah, even though with that sense, I'm still disappointed with the story. I didn't, that's not what I wanted.
It was, it was just too,
because Arden basically just set everything up.
Yeah.
From the get-go. From everything, from the beginning to the end. It was always everything. Which is, it makes me feel as a, as the player or as the main character, feels like I was just following someone's,
yeah,
plans the whole time. Which is bullshit.
Yeah, it is pretty fucked up. Like, you played right into his hands.
Exactly. That's what I feel like.
You can't even get around it.
Exactly.
It's like he, what's so interesting about that, he was able to take the prophecy and twist it to his own advantage.
Yeah.
Which is nuts. Which, that's mad respect for him.
Mm.
But yeah, I mean,
for Noctis, I feel like they turned him a little bitch.
Yeah,
I was not happy with how his character turned.
I know, because, you know, it's cool. It's one thing to be nonchalant and to be kind of, like, inconsiderate. Because, yeah, you're a royal, you know, you've been pampered your whole life sort of thing. But, dude, like, damn, like, you're right. He was just a little kid sometimes. You're
exactly.
Just like,
I hated that.
And I'm just
like, if you compare him to his versus persona, he was a total badass. Like, I mean, there wasn't much, but he was so much badass back then. Now he's a little bitch. Yeah.
I honestly think that it didn't help having all those, like, scenes when he was, like, a little boy, too.
Yeah.
Sweet little boy.
Yeah.
I'm just like, that's cool, but I don't know.
And then, so, what's up with the, yeah, you already talked about it, but the endings cutscene where him and Luna,
yeah, like, or like they look like they're in wedding,
yeah,
clothes,
and they're on, yeah, and they kiss and shit.
There are like people that I've seen online who like wish that they are like alive, but I think it's, to me, I take it symbolically.
Right.
Like, I don't think they're alive. I think they're both dead as dirt. Like,
so they're just at peace.
At peace. That's how I take it. Yeah. It's like, they're in a better place.
Yeah,
they're together now.
Yeah, that's
in
what I'm,
death.
That, yeah, that's exactly,
yeah,
how I see it.
Which is a little bit of that Romeo and Juliet sort of shit, but
yeah,
not technically. So yeah, that's how I took it. And then everyone's like, "Oh no, they're alive!" No, dude, like, don't you understand the prophecy? He has to die.
And she basically died. So she got shivved.
Gosh.
Out of the house. And he was still old, was he? Or was he young again? I forgot. I'm already forgetting.
Oh, you know what? I can't remember either. I want to say he was young.
Yeah, he looked a little young.
Unless he just shaved.
Yeah, he might have just shaved. Yeah. Stupid. Yeah, so I think they were just at peace there. And then there's another final cutscene, right? Or like, he was basically saying goodbye in the campfire.
Oh, yeah, that part was fucking deep. That was more touching than the fucking Luna and Noctis one.
Yeah.
Where he was like, where Gladio fucking cries.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, shit, man. If he's crying, it's really bad. But yeah, he's just,
And then maybe, I think there was one more where it just shows the sword going on. Yeah.
Yeah.
And that was it.
Yeah, like the darkness has ended.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yep.
It's like the end of Matrix 3.
And then, you know what's funny is when it shows the fucking, when it's, that cutscene where it shows Noctis and Luna together in the happy place, it reminded me of fucking Suicide Squad with Joker and Harley Quinn.
Oh, god.
That's what it reminded me of for some reason. Because it was like all bright and shit. You know what I'm talking about, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know how you can make a sequel out of that. Yeah, I don't think you can. Unless you make some 15. Bullshit excuse. But I'd rather them not, honestly. Just give me 16.
Yeah, just do better on your next
Or give me a fucking 7 remake.
Halt all DLC and just start working on the next game.
Yeah.
It's going to take you 10 years anyway. But yeah,
I'm honestly not that excited for the DLC. I mean,
I'm not either.
A lot of people are like, the DLC is going to make it better. The DLC is going to make the story better. The DLC is going to make everything complete. Like, fuck that.
No, it's not even supposed to do that.
Yeah.
I thought it was supposed to be episodes for each character, right?
Something like that. Either way, the game by itself should have did that anyway.
So yeah, and that. I'm not going to... I should have to pay to finish a story.
Exactly.
The main story, you know? It's different if it's a different story, like what Dragon Age does and, you know, different...
Especially once I beat, like, you already beat the game way back, but I beat the game, I'm like, I'm done with it.
I haven't touched it since.
Yeah.
I haven't been able to go back because...
I'm having no motivation to go back, honestly.
It's like, even, like, the weapons you can... Even the other royal arms that I can get.
Yeah.
I'm just like, why? What's the point?
Yeah, like, there's no...
Like, he's dead, technically. Like, I'm just playing a past version of him.
Like, if the combat was fucking amazing, maybe, yeah. But even that is just.
Does a new game plus, does it scale in difficulty?
I didn't check.
I doubt it.
That would suck.
Put all the sliders up for all the difficulty.
Yeah.
Like, all of a sudden there's a hard mode now?
Yeah, they should, because otherwise you'd be walking through that shit.
Yeah, exactly. Armature, 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 armature.
Oh, it's speaking of armature, whatever. That fucking was annoying to pull it off for me. For some reason, I could not, like.
Dude, no, say mine too. Three times at least. I'm just like, hey, what the fuck? Like, I'm all looking at my hands too. Yeah. Like, I never have to do that.
Exactly.
I'm like,
I'm always
okay,
on
one,
this thing.
1, 2, 3.
Exactly. A fucking broken mechanic. Shit.
And gosh, it was like, it was almost like he had to wait for his feet to be planted or something for you to do it.
Well, like, no bad guys or anything? I don't know. Fuck. God. I had to spam this shit. That's never happened.
Yeah, I know. And not to mention that it was like, it was totally useless on some enemies.
Oh, yeah.
It got to a point where it didn't even scale with your strength. And you're just like, man, these weapons suck. Like,
exactly.
Yeah, it's like, I might as well just hack away at it with the one weapon.
Oh my god, that combat could have been so much deeper too.
Did you have a problem with Ignis's scan? How he didn't scan half the shit when he's, like, evaluating or something.
I don't know, but, I mean, he didn't do it all the time.
He didn't do it all the time. That fucking pissed me off.
Yeah.
I need to know my enemy.
Yeah.
Shit.
Let me have the fucking skill. Shit.
I know. Give me the scouter, bitch.
Yeah, like, and we talked about it a while back, like, fucking Noctis didn't have any, like, techniques or anything either.
No, I thought that was a mistake. I thought that was a big mistake.
Yeah.
There was no, like, combo.
Yeah.
Granted, it's just hold circle, but there's no finesse to it.
Yeah.
No finesse to it at all. The only finesse is, strike, warp, strike, warp, strike. That's it? And parry, block, like, block, parry, whatever.
Yeah.
Not to mention, the blocking was so fucking sketchy half the time.
Yeah.
For me. Like, at the beginning of the game, I would hold it, and it didn't work. And then I stopped doing that. I tried to time it. That didn't work. So then I started holding it. And then all of a sudden, it started working for me.
Yeah.
I'm like... It's like, sometimes you just have to sit in the middle of a group of enemies and just hold it.
Exactly. Because you couldn't do anything. Because they would be attacking all different times. Like,
and then you wait for the prompt to come up.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like, felt like a fucking QTE event the whole game.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That was frustrating. And then, there is no, like, dodge attack, I don't... thing, except with a ring, but that was already at the end.
Yeah,
because I think a while back in the Dusk Sky demo, when the combat was completely different, you remember the demo where the whole thing was different, and then I think there was a mechanic where you dodged and you attacked.
I remember that. I remember that.
Yeah,
where he would like sidestep.
Exactly,
yeah,
and
yeah.
attack him.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my fucking goodness! Ah, so much wrong with this game.
I know, it was like just in that amount of time. They had, I think, lessened the value of the game, too.
The what?
Just in that time between the Dusk Sky and the main game, like, they probably already fucking screwed shit up on it.
Yeah, I feel like they could have capitalized or did something with that combat and made that better. Because that was cool. That was a whole... I was into that. Because I know it was different and it was hard to, like, get that grasp on. Because everyone and their mom cried about it, which is why they changed it.
Yeah.
But, like, the whole purpose of him having different weapons was so you could use those different fucking weapons.
I hated not only that they got rid of that mechanic, but I hated that it was so blocky and chunky changing weapons.
Exactly. Like, there was no... because I know in God of War 3, it was like L1X, there was a smooth
transition. It was hella smooth. Yeah, it was a smooth transition. They could have copied that and it would have been cool.
Exactly. There was no smooth transition between
them. Because of those little, like, mess-ups, it made combat just seem so much slower and blocky than it should have been.
Yeah.
And, it just was, wasn't as finessed as I had hoped it would have been.
Yeah, they could have really, like, looking back on it, they could really, like, just... make that Deathsky combat better.
Yeah.
And refine that. That would have been amazing.
Dude, I hope there's a fucking Noctis skin for Nier on him.
Right?
Give him royal arms, man.
Gosh. Yeah. Oh, because... And there's this other thing in that 15, the first trailer for 15, where the invasion, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Because the way it was set out was, like, his weapons were on the bottom left. And they're... He had, like, all of them, like, a good amount.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you could rotate them and, like, pick one in. Oh,
yeah, I remember that.
That was, like, that. Mechanic. It was so cool. They got totally got rid of that. And they give you only 4 options at a time, which is bullshit.
I know! And it
out of all these weapons?
It gets into this fucking Elder Scrolls thing where you stop.
Yeah.
And you're like,
you gotta pick one.
What's my next move going to be? Shit, man. Yeah. Fucking Yu-Gi-Oh! Like, come on.
They could have, like we said it a while back, they could have maybe added another button where it would change the weapons, like a weapon wheel or something. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, dude, you know, they really, really made some bad changes to it. And I think that for people like you especially, who've been really trying to maintain your hype for it for a long time, it just really is like, really, like, damn, man, like, just was expecting so much more.
Yep. And if they, I don't know, I doubt they're gonna stay with the same combat for the next game.
No, I mean, they'd be wise not to.
Yeah, like, but it wouldn't make sense if they wanted to, like, try to improve it story-wise, because story-wise, that's what made sense for
them.
The way his power...
Yeah, because...
But I don't think they're gonna do that again, so I don't know how they would...
No, they would go back to a single weapon.
Yeah, so they can't make it better. So that's already a gone thing.
Yeah, they had their shot. Just
fucked it up.
Time to go back to turn-based.
I wouldn't be surprised.
I
just hope they make 7 really good.
If they went back to turn-based, I have a feeling it would resemble Persona. Mm. Like, that kind of style.
I'm kind of worried about 7 Remake. They better make that combat legit.
The last time I saw the combat, I wasn't super impressed with what they had. But that was really early on.
Yeah. Anything can change it.
Yeah. Yeah, especially within a year or so.
Yeah. Especially how I was surprised they even changed that Deathsky demo to this system in, like, a few, months?
Yeah, exactly.
It was so quick. From a development, I feel like that takes a while.
Exactly. And maybe that's why it wasn't finessed.
Yep. Anything else?
No, we've been talking for an hour and 30 minutes.
That's good.
That's crazy, dude.
I'm gonna upload all this shit.
Good.
I'm trying to think if there's anything else we missed.
No, that's all the negativity I have towards the game. I think that...
Oh, so scores all around? I mean, do you want to score everything or just solid score?
If I'm being as critical as I can possibly be, 7.
Yeah, that's exactly what I have.
7 out of 10.
Yep. 7 out of 15.
Yeah, I think.
It was, like, okay in every sense of the game.
Yeah, you know, really. It wasn't, like, an unplayable game.
Yeah.
So you can't really, I can't really give it any lower than that. But yeah, I can't justify to give it any higher than that, given the amount of time they had with the game.
Yeah, so I feel like they almost should lower the game because of all that time they had.
Yeah, they had plenty of time to make the perfect game.
Yeah.
And, man.
Yeah, the story was okay, the combat was okay, graphics were okay, I guess. I mean, I love the CG cutscenes, but there are only like three of them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Characters were amazing, as I hoped they would be.
Yeah.
Development characters was shit. Oh, man. Ariane wasn't really there. Gentiana was like half-assed.
Yeah.
The four people were...
I think the only thing that made up for it was just their interactions when you're walking around.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
That was the only thing, but then that got old because they started repeating the same lines.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm just talking about back fishing.
Oh, God.
Oh, my gosh. Talking about back... Was it back... Backseat fishing?
Yeah.
Talk about backseat fishing. Every time, too. Like, really?
Wow, that's a small one. Of course.
That was the other thing. It's like, what'd you think of the skills? Is that what they were called? The tree? Whatever.
I had no idea how they fucking work, to be honest. Yeah, Gladio level up the quickest.
Yeah. Or because, actually, Prompto.
Probably. Oh, yeah. Prompto, yeah.
Like, the photography. What the fuck was that? Like, there was no...
Oh, you want to hold five pictures? You can now. You can... His only item slot, you can put a camera strap in it.
What
the hell? He has no health. I'm going to give him a fucking camera strap? It's like, oh, and his abilities? Take a picture in combat?
Yeah, I was like, what? Does he already do that?
What the fuck? Yeah.
Oh, is that your own manual picture? I never tried it, so... What the fuck? Yeah, those skill trees were like half-assed too.
Noctis's skills were good because they like... Because the fishing started lowering hella prices if you got high enough. But I got to the point where I was sick of fucking fishing.
Exactly. There was no fun to it after.
And there was no variety in fish after a while.
Exactly.
I'm still missing fish in my codex. And I'm like, where the fuck are these fish? Like...
Yeah, I think to platinum that game, you have to, like, level 10 that.
Yeah.
Like, fuck that. I'm not doing that.
I gotta go to every little fucking puddle and look for a fish. Like, shit.
Fuck that. I mean, if I could teleport to each one, maybe. But I gotta go all the way there. Fuck that.
Not to mention, like, the fishing mechanic itself was, like, you would do everything right and still damage your line.
Exactly. It was really like, confusing. I didn't even understand that shit. Like,
it wasn't even like real fishing. Like, I fished a lot when I was a kid. I'm like, damn.
Yeah, that's what I was
doing. This doesn't really resemble it too much. You don't have to work that hard to catch a fish.
That's what I'm wondering.
There were some where it took me like 3 minutes to reel one in. And I'm like, the fuck? Because you're like, oh shit.
Yeah.
This is a big one. Because then you have fucking like, Ignis like, oh my. Like,
fuck. Yeah, when it was a big fish, it was impossible, man. Unless you have some weird level super high shit.
Yeah, you have to buy a good rod. That's another thing you get from those mini games, from the Colosseum stuff. You can buy hella better rod.
Yeah, the max I could get was like 2K, I think.
Yeah.
I didn't know you bought that shit.
And so it's like, and the food, it's like, I never had the ingredients to make the good shit. Like, I never wanted to go look for them.
Yeah.
When I started getting hella money, I started buying, like, I'd go to, like, the store and buy, like, two of every item.
Yeah.
Or three of every item so I could make it if I wanted to. I still haven't used my best dishes because I'm saving those for the hard bosses.
Yeah.
Like,
it was funny because I was... Yeah.
I ate pizza so many fucking times and I gave you no idea.
I thought there was something to build up towards, but none of that, you never have to really eat. Might as well eat it whenever you could, because...
Cup noodles?
Yeah.
Like, when you go into the city, I'm like, what the fuck, cup noodles? And then the guy at the dude was like, cup noodles! And I'm like, what is up with everyone in this game? This is hilarious. And it's fucking branding.
Yeah.
It's so funny. And then there's a mission... Okay, so when you go to the rock, where you have to, Gladio comes back from being gone, and he's like, while I was gone, I thought of the perfect thing.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, why were you gone? He never fucking explained that either.
Oh, yeah, that's
why did he get a second scar on his fucking face?
Yeah.
Gosh, dude.
DLC, that's all.
He was fighting Ravis. That's how he really died. Gladio's like, I gotta go. He's like, I'm fucking sick of this guy.
Him on his own. Oh my gosh, that's hilarious. Yeah, that whole little section where, yeah, we didn't talk about that. The little section where they're in their astronaut suits. That was so weird.
Like, oh, I wonder who this is.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, that was a really short piece too.
The damn hazmat suits, stupid ass, gosh, copper ass astronauts. Yeah. Looking like an MTV award.
Good shit.
Oh man. And, yeah, I hated how they never explained that. Absolutely hated that. Oh man.
Yeah, there's skill things, they really. Most of them weren't out of your way either. Like, they just leveled up on their own.
Yeah, it was really the only ones were Ignis and Noctis. Yeah, those are the hard ones.
Yeah.
I still don't think Ignis is at level 10 for me because I got to a point where I wasn't camping.
Yeah,
that
yeah
much
exactly.
Because
I don't have
to
camp
level
anymore.
Up.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, fishing was gets boring. And then, oh yeah, did you ever beat the final one, I guess, where it's all three of them? I tried, it was hella hard. I didn't get
through. No, I didn't beat that one. I got to that one and I just didn't try. I don't even think I attempted it.
Yeah, because I think there's one where you fight all three of them. I think I beat that one and there's another final one.
What?
Yeah.
Like a harder one?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah. Because I'm just
going to equip three spells. Fucking light them up. The one when I did too, I went into Armiger and just fucking wrecked them both. Prompto is always the one that goes down the easiest.
Yeah.
Or I wonder, you know what I thought? I wonder if you unequip their accessories if they're easier to beat.
Yeah, that's what
I'm gonna fucking do that. And give them lower stat weapons too.
Yeah, because I feel like they actually use some of the fucking skills you don't equip too, which is stupid.
Yeah, that is stupid.
That was annoying. Like, they would use skills I don't equip them with. So that was hard. And then Ignis, he always heals them, so you gotta take him out first. What'd you think of the chocobo bullshit? I thought there was up there already.
What are you talking about? Like the skills?
The races.
Oh, I only did two of the races.
Yeah, it is that.
I was like, it would be cool if there were like cooler prizes, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah,
I got
the prizes were weak, and I wish it would have been cool if it was like a lot of people racing. I think that'd be cool.
Yeah,
more than just your four squad members.
It'd be cool if you could like, or have like some type of like, you know, official like scoreboard like with like online, like the online population or whatever. Some online elements would have been nice. Yeah. We're at the day and age where like that's a big deal now, but.
I haven't beaten the turtle thing yet, have you?
No, I haven't even. After I initially tried it, I never went back and tried it. Mm-hmm. But
I don't know if I will.
I don't know either. I'm kind of ready to move on.
Yeah, unfortunately. I don't even know if I'm going to get the DLC at this point. Maybe.
Yeah, same here. I mean, maybe if it's discounted.
I mean, they said there was going to be that multiplayer, right, too?
I heard rumor that there's a way to already do it.
What?
Yeah, which I don't know if it's true or not. It's a way you have to kind of, like, I don't know. Yeah, I have to look that up, because one of my coworkers swore there was a way you could, like, you could unlock it already, and I'm like, that's bullshit. That has to be
it doesn't have an online component.
Exactly.
Yeah, I have to see that first.
That might make it enjoyable, but then again, it's like, who wants to play anyone but Noctis?
Yeah.
What the hell?
Yeah, and plus, unless they make it hard, it's easy as fuck right now. So
yeah.
Like, what's the point? Like, kill stealing everybody? That was my kill.
Gosh. But yeah, that's.
Promptos might be cool because he uses guns. I mean, if they make it the way it was. Before they cut that shit.
Oh, I want to make one comment about that fucking, what's his name? One Eye?
Oh, yeah.
Fucking.
The Behemoth?
Yes.
Yes, talk about that shit.
So, instead of that cool-ass little cutscene where you have to lure him out and bring him around the corner.
Yeah.
They just put fucking dozens of barrels on the ground. And you just fucking shoot at him or you know, strike him or some shit.
And it's a fire. One-hit kill, right?
Yes! And I'm like, oh. You could tell they made it casual on purpose at that point. That was when I knew they did it.
Yeah.
I was like, oh my gosh. Because you remember, he was hella hard to kill
in the demo. Yeah, was.
Like, the scaling in the demo was so nice. It was like, I love this challenge.
Yeah.
I don't feel like it's insurmountable, but I feel like it's definitely a challenge.
Yeah.
There was no punishment in this game.
Nope.
Zero punishment.
Yeah.
For making wrong moves.
Yep.
Oh, man. I just... It just wasn't... By any video game standards, it just wasn't good because the normal mode, if that is the highest you want to go, you need to make that shit hard mode. You need to make your normal mode hard mode and your easy mode normal mode. That's how I feel it should have been. Normal hard, that would have been better. They don't even need it. I can't even imagine what easy mode is.
I know.
What is it? Like, beat the game at level 12? Like,
yeah, or something. I mean, they said you can't die, it's only another thing, but still, you really couldn't die in normal mode either.
Yeah.
Unless you really tried.
Yeah, exactly. You really just had to, like, sit in battle.
Yeah.
For, like, yeah, you just sit there AFK, and that's the only way you'd get a game over.
Yeah.
Gosh, dude.
Fuck. Yeah, and that was the only type of hunt that had that cool, different...
area.
Like, yeah, and it was like... It actually had segments to it. That's the only type, and they fucked it up.
Yep.
Oh, and another thing for me was that... This one's a little nitpicking, but I wasn't a fan of Luna's voice.
Yeah,
I didn't like her voice. I mean, I usually like... What is it? What is the accent?
British?
Yeah, I usually like those voices, but... The way she sounded, I wasn't a huge fan of. And I think she had a different voice actor in the Kingsland, too.
Yeah, she's...
So that was kind of fucking weird, too.
I know, I was... Yeah.
And she even looked different in Kingsland.
Yeah, I don't know. I didn't think she ever looked that good anyway.
Yeah, that's the other thing. It's like, this is another nitpick, but I wasn't really attracted to Luna.
No.
Something about her felt a little... She had a little baby face, I think.
She did, and she just
had like
awkward-ass looking body.
Yeah, if you look at her compared to Stella, I know everyone's crying, but like... I know people get mad when you mention Stella anywhere. But Stella looked way better than her, I'm just saying.
Yeah, Gladio's sister was hotter than Luna. Shit.
Yeah.
I was really hoping Noctis would hook up with her. Be like, yeah, fuck my wedding.
I mean, she was all over him.
Right?
Like, right there, it's free pizza.
Free pizza, just like that DLC pizza. That pre-order pizza.
Oh my gosh. Oh shit.
That's it.
So overall, 7, which isn't bad. It's still good. I mean, it's okay. It's an okay.
That's the best score I can give it.
That's actually being generous.
Yeah.
Fuck.
I mean, if you take those, if I was just judging it on those last 4 chapters, it'd be a fucking 5.
Well, actually, it wasn't. I don't know. It's hard because I actually enjoyed the ending, except for the story. The story was kind of weak, but the atmosphere was kind of cool, I think. Mm. But the effort definitely makes up for it. Mm. But everything else is, yeah. And like I said, this is going back, but all this cut content! I think I showed you that a while back, or talked about it, where... There's a video online where it shows all the trailers that have cut shit. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of shit. It's unfortunate. I don't know if you remember, but you could actually control the dog, and like walk with walk as the dog. There's a video of that.
Maybe vaguely, but I don't know.
Yeah, you could be the dog and walk around the city. That's fucking cut that.
Okay, that would have fucking changed anything.
Yes. Like, it's cut content. I don't give a shit.
I'm glad they cut that shit.
No.
Fucking hate that dog that fucking ruins the continuity of the fucking game.
Still, cut content, bruh. Noctis OG. Fuck. Oh my goodness, there's so much awesome cut content. Like, even Regis just holding Noctis, remember? I don't know, in the rain?
Yeah.
All that shit was gone.
I hated how weak the fucking King Sword was.
Oh my god,
yes. When you get out of that level, it's like...
Yeah.
It's worse than the first sword you have, basically.
Yeah. I was like, this is gonna be the shit.
I was like, oh yeah, this is the, like, Ultima Blade right here, baby.
Exactly.
And no wonder you died, Regis. Your sword fucking sucks. No wonder you didn't lift that sword. You're like, I got a better chance with my fist.
Exactly.
Throws the sword on the ground. I don't need this shit.
Exactly. That's why he finds it.
No wonder Ravis died. Shit.
That's why he didn't even put up a fight. He's like, this sword's not gonna help.
You pull it out, the demons just start laughing.
Oh, fuck.
Shit.
I forgot his name. I don't know if you remember. The guy who killed him? The knight dude? But yeah.
He was already dead, though, name. Right? Yeah, I can't remember the dude's name.
Yeah. See, oh yeah! Speaking of dudes. Oh. That's my other gripe is that there was not enough humanoid fucking bad guys.
Right.
I don't want to fight other fucking humans.
That's true.
Shit! I was sick of fighting these metal motherfuckers. They weren't fun to kill.
Yeah, but like, granted, like.
What?
Granted, like, most Final Fantasy games, you don't fight a lot of people.
Yeah, you do.
No, like, the majority of the game's monster fights, though.
Yeah, but still, there's a good amount.
Okay.
This one didn't have any.
Yeah, that's true.
Is Aranea?
Mm-hmm.
Revis?
Yeah, but, yeah, you don't fight him, really.
I mean, he's a half-demon.
Yeah.
That was a cool battle, actually.
Wait, Revis?
The brother, what's his name?
Yeah.
Yeah. He was a half-demon, remember? He wakes up when he's dead.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah. Okay, sorry. I was like, I thought you meant earlier in the game. I'm like, shit, you never fight that dude?
I wish you did. But yeah, it was him, Aranea, and Arden. And that's pretty much it.
Yep, that's it.
Fucking trash, bruh. Give me a Sephiroth battle.
Yeah,
give me a Sephiroth secret battle.
Yeah, man. Where's that secret dungeon with Sephiroth then?
That would be fucking sick. Fuck! There's so much shit!
With my Buster Sword.
Yeah, that DLC.
Buster Sword DLC.
I would have fucking bought that. Or at least fucking Cloud's outfit. I mean, they gave
Soldier outfit.
The what?
The soldier outfit.
Yeah.
The fucking pauldron with the thing sticking out.
Yeah. Or give me his Versus 13 outfit at least. Yeah. Please. Shit.
Nah, man. This was definitely, like...
Rushed,
could have done better, like, it was like shit. But I'm glad I got through it. I'm glad it's over.
10 years, bruh. 10 years for nothing. Well, we can look forward to 16 now. I really have high hopes for that shit. I'm hoping they learn a lot from this bullshit they did.
Yeah.
It's another 10 years. Fuck.
You know, we'll probably have kids by the time the game comes out.
You can't even play that shit. Our kids are gonna have to play that for us.
I can't see the TV. Tell me what's happening.
Oh my god. So sad. Yeah.
What sucks is this was a lot of people's first Final Fantasy game. Oh, I love this series! I'm gonna play the other ones! Don't! They're nothing like this!
Yeah. You're gonna get wrecked.
You're gonna get wrecked.
You're not gonna have a chance.
You're gonna be attacking over and over. You're gonna lose.
Learn to guard. Fuck. Use that Phoenix down for once.
I loved... The one thing I did love was the confused effect.
Oh, yeah.
How you had to do inverted controls.
Yeah, cool.
That was cool. I liked that touch.
Yeah, you couldn't do that to bad guys. I mean, you couldn't do any of that shit to bad guys.
Yeah.
You don't have spells.
The toad one was pretty funny.
The what?
The toad.
Oh, yeah.
Gosh, that one was hella funny. Just, like, hopping hella high, like, to get out of the way. Other than that, I don't feel like the other ones were too big of a deal. Poison wasn't that big of a deal.
Yeah, I got petrified.
Yeah, that one's scary.
How much do you shatter or what?
You don't. You're invincible, actually.
What?
Yeah, when you do it. You don't even take damage.
It's fucking stupid.
It's hella stupid.
Wow, you just shattered like Kratos in God of War.
Right from what I thought was going to happen. When I first happened, I'm like, shit, I thought of God of War. Yeah. Immediately, I'm like, I'm going to fucking shatter now when they hit me.
Automatic game over. Isn't that how it was in the other Final Fantasies? If you get petrified or no?
I know you still took damage.
Yeah.
I know you weren't fucking invincible like this game.
Bullshit.
Like, yeah, they swing at you and it's 0-0-0-0.
I didn't realize that, because as soon as I get petrified, I got immediately unpetrified. Because I thought I was going to die.
Yeah, no, you can just wait it out. That's what I eventually
did. That is so bullshit.
Unless you get some fucking chips from the kitchen.
Oh my god, make a sandwich.
I literally thought of just getting a rubber band and taping my R1 and circle together and then just letting the controller sit there.
Fudge.
Oh, dinner time. Okay, let me tape my circle.
Fudge. 7 out of 10. That's so generous.
I know, but...
I mean, yeah, I agree with that. Everything was okay. Nothing was good. Ifrit made up for it. I say that all the time.
What is that Ifrit edition?
Fuck. Yeah, just Ifrit and that's it. I would pay for that. No, I'm just kidding. $10 just for that segment. Anything else? We're getting 2 hours, bruh. Two hours for this bullshit.
No, I got nothing. Don't you have work?
At 1. What time is it?
It's almost... It has to be 12 at least.
Oh my god.
You have work at 1?
Well, it's 1:15.
Okay, gosh. Damn, okay.
Are you going to drop me off?
Yeah, of course. At this point, yeah, I am.
I didn't realize. I thought it was going to be like 12.
Damn, man.
We're going to be late for this.
This is how angry this game made us.
Yeah, fuck.
It 2 hours?
It deserves a 2-hour review. This is bullshit. 10-hour game. 10-hour waiting. 10-year.
Change the channel to Strictly Enemy. Shit.
Yeah. Dude, that would have been awesome, actually. Enemy.
I wish you could change the time that's advertised so it's like it reads like 2 minutes instead of 2 hours so everyone clicks on it.
Well, I don't
break
know.
It up.
People should probably click on it because it's 2 hour review.
Yeah.
Fuck. Yeah. Any last words?
No.
10 years, guys. 10 years for a 7.
10 years for nothing.
Yep. Hopefully not another 10 years for 16.
Let's hope that Last Guardian's better for you.
Yeah, that's what I'm hoping. I feel like it should. I mean, I think it's going to be a shorter game, so it won't be as, like, dragged out. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, 10 years of sadness. Not what we wanted.
Nope.
No Stella.
Broken me out.
Hashtag Stella.